Something I would be willing to visit for no
two
reason in particular.
Things I want to do here.
And what might those be?
Well, the first is to handle the police force. Second is Gunther believes in a scorched earth policy to all other religions. So we got
a religion of peace.
Yes.
He is wearing about like 100 pounds of armor. So.
You know when they do the 40, they're like just wearing Under Armour.
He's wearing 800 units of armor. This is over armor.
Yeah.
It's really overpriced, correct?
Yeah, they're not wearing... Well, that's Under Armour for you.
Yep.
Womp, womp. Boom.
But if you don't wear it, you're not a cool cat, I think.
Yeah.
I remember that was... there was something kind of like Under Armour. Maybe it was Under Armour. It was getting real big back when I was in high school, and all of a sudden, all the guys who thought they were hot shit on the football team decided to get really weird ones, like full-body ones, just to like, really?
Well, let's see. When I was in middle
school,
it's like,
dude, you're still third string. It doesn't matter.
When I was in middle school, it was all about the starter jacket.
Yeah.
We all got jackets. It was a small school.
If you weren't the counterculture kids who wore Baja jackets, you remember, or Baja coats, you remember those?
Yes. How could I forget?
It was either Baja jackets or starter jackets. That was it.
Did I do it wrong? Am I supposed to hit the switch or no?
Yeah.
So you're going down. Go downstairs.
I mean, technically, you could have just warped straight to the bonfire, but why would we do that?
I didn't think this was a warp one.
It's a covenant one.
It counts as a covenant bonfire.
Oh, shit. Oh, well.
It's called Darkmoon Tomb or something like that.
It's a refresher for the viewers.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly. Remember where we are.
Exactly.
Getting very disjointed here.
So... Actually, if this is an old world boss, well,
it's an old world boss, but I think you got this.
Let's move away from the spear for a bit and head back to Quilog again, because you know Quilog got shat on a lot in the DLC, and I'm sorry about it, Neil.
Yeah, this guy doesn't really have much against split weapon damage, so that should be fine.
This is a pretty much like an old school Mega Man boss once you figure out the pattern you win.
Mm-hmm.
Until then, you're going to die a lot, so.
I don't approve your religion. Fuck off. I'm here to break stuff.
Greetings!
Where's the bathroom?
Hey, am I not supposed to...
I think I'm lost. That sounds like a girl's name. Are you a girl?
He's very sensitive about that subject.
His dad was probably something like Andre. Okay, there's boss.
Funny that you mentioned that, too.
Thought I was going to shoot something at me.
That's not a wrong assumption.
In fact, I think that may be his entire MO.
So, how do you like endurance running?
Yeah, what was that about your 40?
Yeah, you should be worrying about your 10K.
So yeah, dude's got some mad ups, and he also has a whole bunch of ranged attacks for you.
By a whole bunch, you mean three.
You know?
Yeah.
He's gonna use them a lot.
I guess cover isn't helping me here.
Well, yes, it will.
It can help a bit with the crossbow bolts, but you can just block those with your shield super easy. Yeah.
It'll also usually block the smaller bolts, it's just the big ones you have to really watch out for.
Actually, yeah, at this point you can probably tank the small bolts too. Small,
I probably could have two-handed that.
Yeah, when you get close, you want to maximize damage because he keeps warping on you.
Oh, he can roll under. How about that?
You're just going to keep going down this really
long
hallway.
Wow.
That was deceptive. Wow. I didn't think they'd pile up to do that much damage, man.
Yeah, they do.
Huh.
So yeah, those are his three attacks.
Okay, cool.
He has the big ball thing.
Yeah, which goes to the pillars. It kind of registered the second time. I was like, huh, I should be two-handing this.
Yeah.
Maybe I should arrow do bolts, more damage.
Yeah, his arrow bolts and the magic, like the little small missiles, they don't go through the pillar, so you can use those as cover. Oh, yeah. Big one does, though.
Big one has no clip.
Oh, so my souls are really all the way down there. That's unfortunate.
Time for the claw.
Because I want a long-range weapon.
Okay. Is there any real way to tell which sort of spell he's about to cast, or no?
Yeah,
when he floats up,
brings
in the
his
air,
arm up, and it's glowing. That he's gonna do the big one. If you see him raise up and no glowing, then he's doing the crossbow.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Like when he's floating upwards, he's gonna fire his crossbow at you.
Is it a crossbow? I thought it was a bow based on something you can get.
Yes, it's a bow. It's just weird. So you can like fire multiple shots at you. That's not what bows should do.
There we go. Got me in kind of a weird spot there.
Oh god, you barely survived that.
If you couldn't guess, that's magic damage, so you can take against that.
Yeah, you could dress
specifically for the
occasion.
He keeps wanting to reuse the same one. There he goes.
He's got you pinned down with magic bullets.
Oh, my character just keeps firing out the magic bullet, so you're stuck there.
I cast magic missile.
Many.
Thank God we got our souls back.
You can tell when he's attacking, because it just hear clack, 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 clack.
It's like I can see into the future of the stream.
Yeah.
Like, eventually, Geoff's gonna kill this dude. It may take a bit, but it's gonna happen.
No, it won't take long. He's doing crazy
damage. Just happened.
Yeah. Handled.
Nice hat. I have one just like it. Kind of.
No,
no, that's a different hat.
Yeah, that's different.
I said kind of. It's a cosplay hat.
He slipped it in there at the end.
Oh, so he cursed you from beyond the grave.
Welp.
Woo!
I don't care.
Half health.
That was a long walk.
The room has gotten much shorter now, but you should definitely go check it out.
You also got a soul.
So yeah, that's Dark Sun Gwendolyn.
Guardian of deserted Anorlondo.
That's funny,
because
we met
someone. God of the
someone.
Ghost Town.
The soul can make two items, neither of which are going to be useful to you.
That seems to be kind of an ongoing thing with boss souls, except for Quilogs.
His stuff is more for faith-based characters.
It's the kind of thing where most boss weapons are only good for
gotta earn
levels,
your
so
place, son!
You'll find one. So eventually you find one that actually works for the build you're going for.
Hey.
Where's so yeah, this
stuff?
Is like a Tomb of the Giants kind of tune. There's just a huge grave up here. And owned by the chest.
What a jerk boss. How do you
surprise,
like that?
Surprise, the box is empty.
I destroyed your side chair thing.
Take that chair.
Take that. Yeah.
Miracle Sunlight Blade. Oh, this is one I think I heard of a long time ago.
Sunlight Blade is pretty good. I think it's the second most powerful one. I think Dark Moon's still the most powerful. But yeah, you can enchant weapons with it.
Man, I wish I got this earlier. I would have built my faith to where I could actually use it. Rats.
The thing is, it only has one cast, and it lasts about 30 seconds.
Oh, really?
But during that time,
you were a monster.
250 more damage or something. Granted, you need a weapon that is upgraded with special stuff.
Yeah, something that isn't already.
So you can
use your claw.
I have a lore question.
Sure.
So this is the armor of the lady who's the firekeeper, I think, right?
Yep.
Correct.
So,
in fact, you should go visit her right now.
Is
ask her some questions.
The big lady upstairs, who is Gwendolyn's sister, are they basically kind of part of the same religion, to where they get along and everything okay?
So
I was under the impression that this lady was in service to Gwen up there, or whatever her name is, the big lady. What's her
Guinevere.
Name? Guinevere, thank you.
Guinevere,
yes.
Well, no, actually, she was in service to the person you just killed.
Yeah.
Gwendolyn.
Oh.
But yeah, Gwendolyn.
Hence
is
why
there.
Her
because
armor
I know I know things happen if you kill Gwendolyn. But
yes.
Do other things happen if you kill
Yeah. So the firekeeper out there was in service to Gwendolyn because they're both Blade of the Dark Moon.
Huh. Mm-hmm.
So
she
should
is
I
a Blade of the
is
Dark
she
Moon.
Going to be at that spot where I saw her in your stream, or is she going to be at the bonfire still?
No, she should be at her bonfire.
Okay.
Yep.
And by the way, you should take a look at this room before you leave, like the big box that was behind all the other chests.
Mm-hmm.
The big box?
Yeah, I mean, Gwendolyn was protecting something if you listen to his cutscene.
No.
So you'll learn about that in post.
Coffin?
It is a coffin, yes.
Gwen's?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's what he said.
That said, if you should get a good look at it.
It's a pretty big coffin.
It's pretty massive.
Scrub.
You broke that guy's chair too.
Exactly. Look at that. I broke his his dollhouse chair.
Well, Gwendolyn wasn't that big. I mean, he was about your size.
Well, Gwendolyn's, yeah, but that's right. That's where Gwendolyn was chilling out, sitting by his dad's coffin.
He was probably sitting up the chair.
Yeah.
He broke his chair. Big dick.
This chair is just right. So yeah, the interesting thing is that the covenant that is attached to Guinevere, the worship, like the Sunlight Guard or the Princess Guard, of course, I just saw it. But the covenant that's attached to the Princess Guard is attached to Guinevere. But as you've said, or Guinevere. God, fucking too many Gwens.
Yep.
However,
just call her Papa Gwen,
Guinevere...
Big Gwen, and oh, hey, lady. Oh,
yeah, she's not very happy with you.
Oh,
Guinevere up here, though.
Wait, I wanted to hear her discussion after I pissed off you know who.
Well, then you shouldn't have warped there.
I was told to warp here to talk to her. I assumed she'd be like, "Hey, asshole," and she wouldn't attack me until I did the other thing.
Well, actions do speak louder than words.
Damn it, Kuvo, you
misled
me.
Yeah, she will attack you as soon as you get near her.
Yep.
And
well,
she does say stuff.
I mean,
the one where she yells at you is if you actually go into Dark Anilondo.
Yeah, I just wanted to see that.
Well, then you have to do other things.
I think that's her parry.
Well, I mean, she's not going to appear and talk to me anymore, is she?
Nope.
Do it.
You could run away from her.
Different type of completion. We already saw that other scene in some other stream, but.
Yeah, I wanted to see that because, you know, we were discussing on top of it. Hey, elevator, you coming back?
Nope.
She put it down permanently. It also looks funny. She just runs at you with her dagger in front of her.
I'm gonna get you.
You better not tumble down here, Missy. Now, I want to hear that discussion.
Discussion?
You have to go commit, like, regicide or something.
I don't think it's regicide when it's... No.
I thought that was for our royalty. Oh, well.
Well, regicide implies king, though.
Yeah. I thought it was
and
royalty.
And also, like, an actual thing and not an illusion. But that's...
Shh. Why'd you warp back down here?
So you could reset the admonishment.
Yeah, I want to hear her getting all pissed off and stuff because the stream, you know, I couldn't really hear it.
Mm-hmm. I think that only happens in Dark Anilondo, though.
Yeah, I've gotta do stuff to the big lady, and then.
Well, then why didn't you just warp?
Well, then why didn't you just warp to her fire?
I used a homeward bone.
But and then you had a bonfire that you could warp from.
Oh.
Oh my god.
Confusing me, GM.
He's not cut out for being a jerk like this. It doesn't come naturally to him.
I just reset the bridge. That was part of my plan.
Yeah,
now,
sure.
Now, I'm gonna warp.
Now you warp back to the bonfire you were just standing at.
Mm-hmm. But you have to put the bridge in the lowered position to get back down.
Don't care.
Never mind.
I think we're all just very mixed up right now. We're having some very strong emotions.
I'm not mixed up. I know exactly what's going on.
I like that it's taking you a bit to figure out how to murder.
So what weapon are we going to do this with?
You are indecent.
I am not a fan of boob windows myself.
This is a house of worship. You will dress decently, madam.
Well, she's the deity.
Don't care.
I do what I want.
This is a wholesome LP, damn it. Haven't said that for about 90 episodes, so I think everybody needed a reminder.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this cutscene plays out the same way, except you don't get a voiceover, because obviously you killed the person who was doing the voiceover.
I didn't kill her, I ran away.
No, the voiceover that Gwendolyn does.
Oh, you know, Gwendolyn was the one who did the voiceover. Oh, shit, I'm sorry. Yeah. I thought that was the firekeeper going, "You asshole!"
Nope.
The firekeeper also says something which you managed to avoid hearing.
Well, you're putting a lot of effort into jumping off of this ledge.
Man, I wanted to hear that. Oh, well.
Well, the firekeeper will be at the bottom of the stairs outside the cathedral.
I thought she was the one who shouted stuff. I didn't realize that was Gwendolyn.
She doesn't have the voice for that. I mean, that would be like, what, half a mile away? She's just shouting it.
On the other hand, Gwendolyn is as you can see, a master illusionist. And, with the boss fight where he made the hallway longer and stuff.
You notice that the sentinels are gone.
Yeah.
Yes. And they've sent some dark moon blades to you.
Mm-hmm. They're both pretty weak.
Mm-hmm.
There's a crying baby outside. Respawn, be quiet, apartment complex.
There's a crying baby in our.
This is why I'm getting a house. Crying babies all the time.
It's all about the babies.
Babies. Are you going to keep turtling?
You can kick.
See,
you
I know. Live.
I can't kick.
I live in apartments in college town, so I just get drunk people all the time. I actually, yesterday, one of the guys who lives here, because I live in an apartment with seven other people that, like, has street level access.
I tried kicking again.
He's trying. One of the people actually came in through the window because he didn't think his key worked.
Smart.
So that was fun. Like at 2 in the morning, I come out of my room and he's like putting the screen down on our living room floor, and I was just like, yeah. These are the people I live with. Oh, sick dodge. There.
He kept trying to parry me, and I was kind of like, motherfucker.
These dudes are so weak, except they're kicking Geoff's ass.
No, the problem was that guy kept trying to parry me, and I accidentally goofed up the. You can't kick with this. He does the whole thing like that.
Yeah.
I goofed it up.
Backflip.
It didn't trigger when I wanted it to, and he parried me.
Yeah, but the thing about the Circus of Life flip is that they try to parry it, but they can't.
Yeah, I know.
So you can still get the hit in.
That's why I was trying to do it, but it didn't trigger.
Yeah, you can abuse their AI.
Yep. Well.
So yeah, the
I guess Anor Londo is closed for business.
Mm-hmm. You've kind of taken
shit
it out.
Lord.
I do think that the Smith is still just doing his thing. He didn't really have allegiances.
Yeah, the Smith doesn't give a crap.
Smith don't care.
Forge he can. Strong he am.
Hey. Range using battle? Magic, are we? So I see she has a parrying dagger. That's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
and she will parry you. The only way to break through the parry stance, if she decides not to lower it, is to kick her.
Yeah, and so she's using
she,
dark
she's doing a fat
right
tumble.
There.
Interesting.
That's heavy armor.
Yeah, brass set's heavy-ish.
It's not I think
very
it's
good.
Like, one of the heavier sets of the medium armor. It's not very good, but it looks awesome. So
it's, funny cause it's funny because I'm just watching the roll. It looks like, you know, just like a fat, a really unathletic person trying to do an awesome roll and screwing it up.
Gunther's just looking at that. Do I really look like that?
It's just like a fat kid on YouTube. Okay, guys. I'm going to do parkour today.
Firekeeper soul. Right, excellent. Estus plus 20 5. 20-foot
rule.
Yeah, but yep. You can't warp from that bonfire anymore.
It's I don't care. Our work here is done.
Well, yeah.
You also can't visit that bonfire anymore.
So let me see. So as far
but
as...
But then what would you ever really have to do?
Where is the nearest bonfire to warp from? The one down there is dead. This
just
one's
homeward
dead.
Bone.
That one's dead. Aren't they?
Well, the one below you is not dead, but no. You have a homeward
no,
bone,
it's just the one that Firekeeper was attending.
Oh.
Yeah, also yes. The Princess Chamber still should be there.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
I could just,
You having some difficulty, Squint?
No, it was stretching.
Oh, okay.
Why did it sound
it sounded like someone punched you in the chest, but you just kept going.
Oh. it's right there. Sorry.
Squint.
Stretching some more.
Sorry, bro.
But yeah, the only one that actually goes out is the Firekeeper's bonfire. So, now you can warp to that, but you can't warp from it. You also can't rest at it.
Let's see what else we can do. We should go pay someone a visit.
Who do you recommend?
Oh, what someone are you talking about?
Let's go to find Mr. Crow at Firelink.
Oh, I'm already heading there.
Awesome.
Perfect. It's like you read your mind.
Yep. You haven't been to the Undead Asylum in a while.
Oh, why are we going back there?
Well, because we have to pay another person a visit. Someone warm. Something soft.
Precious. I need to... I was thinking about Homeward Bones. I've still got several, but I'd like to stock up.
You're very close to the end of the game.
Yeah.
It's
not to mention, you could probably buy them from someone around here.
What happens if you kill Frampt at this point? I guess you can't. He just goes away.
Yeah, he just calls you a
fool. Yeah, he just runs away, being like... Rrr, rrr, rrr,
rrr. Would I have any repercussions at this point if I whack him?
I mean, you could whack him
once.
Well, you won't be able to feed stuff to him anymore.
I don't need to. Hey, Frampt. How you doing?
Hey, buddy. I mean, Chester was saying that serpent. Who could he possibly be talking about?
Yeah.
It's not like there's two of these guys wandering around.
Yeah, I know. More than one serpent, that's crazy.
These games have a one snake limit. He's still just getting up like, huh?
Are you throwing stuff at me?
No, in my mouth.
Well, man, this guy's hitbox is deceptive.
I hope you fall in.
Yeah.
Tell him you're sorry with the carving.
Man, this guy does not want to get pissed off.
He's a pretty cool dude.
Sorry, fool. You could not be.
That was a warning shot.
I shall slumber. I'm not the chosen one. Dude,
have you
been missing out
you.
On this? I've got all the Lord souls. I kept the camera on his face. Watch these zooms down. I just kept it on his face the whole time. Just something about it looked really funny.
See you later, shit lords. Beautiful. You're not Alexander. See, yeah, there's that taken care of.
Yep, there's
that. Pissing off everyone at this point.
Yep.
You should go curl up like a ball.
Curl up like a ball. Again.
I think you have more subscribers than me, actually.
They'll all leave when this LP's over and it's time for more boring ones.
Your fair weather subscribers.
Yes. That's how it's gonna go.
Giap was so cool until he sold out and did all sorts of history bullshit.
It's that close up in slow mo just gets me every time.
The reaction shot that doesn't work because of
yes, dude, they're just like fuck.
I think I mentioned this in a much earlier episode, but if you've ever,
I love how he kind of rolls when he lands. Watch that, because he's all balled up. He doesn't just plant himself; he falls and rolls a little.
In games like, I think it was Dead Rising, where if you are wearing a mask in the game, you'll be wearing the same mask in cutscenes. So,
yeah,
like when all this dramatic, serious stuff is going on, you have like a foam dinosaur head on,
like the Lego hat.
And what's supposed to be like a very serious or grim look is just this screen full of dinosaur face.
Anyway, Jeff, do you remember where the crow was?
Yep.
You gotta go give her an item.
What am I gonna give her? The extra rubbish?
Well, you could. You just get Titanite back, but. You have to give her your anime.
Oh, wait, hang on,
hero.
She's talking.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, it's the same thing.
Yeah. Not much new.
Yeah. So yeah, give her
kinda
your
one
anime
track
hair.
Mine.
My anime.
Yeah, sorry, but you're gonna have to give your anime hair up.
Yeah.
Oh, give man. It up for Lent. Easter is tomorrow, after all.
Mm-hmm.
Oh man. Give it up. Where's my anime hair? I guess it's at the bottom with the miscellaneous stuff. Yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
Sunlight Maggot. Drop.
It's an unmatched helm.
Mm-hmm. Quit and reload.
Show off that sweet, sweet opening screen.
Kind of wish you didn't have to quit and reload for this.
Well, you got to see a brief little info plug on the Katarina helmet, and I am level 87.
Oh. Yeah, you're about average. Most people finish the game around 90, so yeah.
Yeah, that's about right.
People claiming I'm overleveled and super grinding. Harumph.
Well, your level's about average. Your gear is probably way better than that.
Yeah, it's all about
pick
the gear.
Pick up item. Old Witch's Ring.
Ah, what does it say? Do you happen to know any old witches?
You know that you haven't murdered yet?
One or two? An old ring with no use. Engraved minutely with indecipherable script, but seemingly useless. I take this to the witch's sister or something like that?
That may be worth trying. Now, it's also worth noting...
So wait, there's the old witch's ring and there's the tiny witch's ring. Is that the other one? What was it called?
Tiny being's ring.
Yeah, tiny being's ring.
Tiny beings, I'm sorry, I don't know what...
That said, those two items that you just said are potential starting gifts. Like, the witch's ring and the tiny being's ring.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's not like she's gonna start fighting you or anything.
Yeah. Well, it depends on which one I need to talk to. If I need to talk to her or her sister.
Layla, my dear sister. Quayla, what is it?
Wait a second, she thinks I'm Quaylag?
Yeah. She might!
Well, all the eggs are dead, but I'll be okay as long as I have you.
You're holding a weapon.
Gunther's suddenly like, "Oh, sister, please reinforce my Estus flask." What happened to your voice? Nothing. I'm a spider lady.
As you hold the weapon that's made from her sister's soul.
Yeah, you're really hitting all the notes here, aren't you?
Could we possibly make this any more fucked up?
You, since it's made
out of her leg... Oh, I'm sorry, that was my sword! I mean, my leg!
Yeah, since it's made out of her leg, you just kind of use it to pat her on the shoulder.
I'm still here!
I'm sorry.
Well... Gunther's a horrible human being.
Yeah. I blame
well, technically
France.
Technically, he's not a human being at all.
Probably also Gwendolyn for some reason. He seems very blamable for all of this.
So, we ready to beat the game, or?
Yeah.
Are you gonna kill her?
Let's beat it, I guess.
Are you gonna kill her?
You can kill her, and she does drop stuff.
What does she drop?
A Firekeeper soul.
And some humanities, I think.
Yeah.
You know what?
You know, she is a Firekeeper after all.
I'm thinking no.
I keep her just for the fact that that's a useful Bonfire of the Warp, too. Mm-hmm. But you're about to beat the game, so it really doesn't matter.
Yeah,
and you can take the items in the new game plus. So
you could always go kill all the all the blacksmiths if you really want.
No.
The only question is
you drop
how far
unique
you
items every single like all of them except Rickard because I don't think you can kill Rickard.
You could try. It's probably a pansy. So, viewer, that wraps it up here. I guess next time we will start the session where hopefully I'll beat the game, or probably I will beat the game, depends upon what's left.
You know, I can't help but feel like we're forgetting something. Eh, probably not. For nowhere in the world could there be a boy as true as